Good morning. We are continuing our Women's Care Wednesday segments this morning with this very special doctor. We have Dr. Indermaur here joining us today to talk about a very important subject, which I'm glad we're talking about. January was Cervical Cancer Awareness Month. We're now in the month of February, which is still Cancer Awareness Month. And this is extremely important to talk to women about cervical cancer. Good morning, doctor. Good to see you.
Good morning. Hello.
So let's talk about cervical cancer. Why is this something that we still really need to get the message out about for women?
Well, cervical cancer is actually one of the few cancers that we could actually prevent. And so it's very important to get the word out with regards to cervical cancer, because women and young women are still dying from this cancer every day, and it's very preventable.
So let's talk about that. What is the best way to prevent it? Who should be making sure they are? Let's talk about the vaccine. I'm assuming that's where we're going next, correct?
Yes. So cervical cancer is actually caused by virus, HPV, or human papilloma virus, if you want to look it up. And it's one of the few cancers that's actually caused by a virus. And we have an excellent vaccination program with regards to HPV that prevents the precancerous cells as well as obviously the cancer cells. And this is a vaccine that children should get between the ages of 11 and 12.
Okay.
And unfortunately, in the United States, our vaccination rates are pretty low, but this is a vaccine that could make a huge difference to somebody 10, 15, even 30 years down the line to prevent cancer from happening.
So if we are talking about young girls getting this vaccine, is this something that they go to their regular pediatrician for? How do parents kind of help decipher where to go and what to do?
So typically, the pediatricians typically bring it up to parents when they come in for their normal annual pediatric examination, but also GYN doctors can give the vaccination to the kids as well. If somebody is missed and coming in later on, maybe in their late teens or early 20s, they could also receive the vaccination as well.
Well, and let's talk about that. And now let's talk about the age group that I'm assuming that we're also needing to tell the importance of pap smear, which you commonly hear. Talk about why that is so important, what you guys are looking for.
Yes. So in the world of GYN, cervical cancer also is one of the few cancers that we actually have a screening method for. So most of us know all about pap smears in general. So we still recommend pap smears that look specifically for the precancerous cells for cervical cancer. In addition, we now actually test for HPV depending on the age. So if a patient is less than 30, but older than 21, we actually do only pap smear testing and then test for HPV if a pap smear is abnormal. When a patient is older than 30, we actually test for both the pap smear and the HPV to kind of triage those patients and see if they need further testing to look for the precancerous cells.
Talk about if someone is diagnosed, you do find cervical cancer. What are the chances? What happens after that? What are the success rates that you're seeing?
Right. So as long as somebody's been following up, most of the time we're actually picking up the precancerous cells, which we can treat and hopefully prevent that cervical cancer from down the line. And that's what we usually perform what's called an excisional biopsy, where we remove those cancer cells and then we watch them closely. If they progress or have signs of cancer, it depends on which stage they are, how advanced the cancer is, but most of them are early and we could do surgery to help cure them.
Well, doctors, we wrap up here. What's your take home? What do you really want women and certainly parents that are watching this morning, what do you want them to know and really to make sure to remember?
I think it's just really important to talk to your physicians about the HPV vaccination so that we could prevent this cancer from occurring, especially in our younger adults.
This is why we love our partnership with Women's Care Florida, because we can have important conversations like this, get the word out, help with that. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your time, doctor.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
And of course, we'll put more info on our website as well.